Welcome to Mind Your Body. I'm Stephanie Stevens. As we age, our lips get thinner, which is not helpful if you already have thin lips like I do, and like my mother and my grandmother did. Maybe you've seen lip enhancements that you thought were way too much, and you've wondered about the best method to achieve a natural look. Well, so have I. That's why I'm excited to be here in Beverly Hills today with plastic surgeon Dr. Francis Palmer. He's a lip augmentation expert. Hi, Dr. Palmer.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. And you know, I've been so interested in this subject for a long time for obvious reasons. I remember collagen, one of the first fillers back in the day. We had silicone droplets, definitely controversial, they still are. Fat transfer, some doctors say, unpredictable. Now we have hyaluronic acid, or HA, fillers like Juvederm and Restylane. I had Juvederm, and I remember my doctor saying, this might not work too well because you don't have enough base lip. Well, guess what? It didn't. Tell us about fillers, your opinion, the pros and the cons.
Well, I think fillers are fantastic. So let's go back to lips. You know, I wrote a book that really defines beauty for both men and women, and it's based upon shapes of ideal features of the face or body. And so the face, one of the top three features are the cheeks, the eye area, and the lips. The lips have the power to soften the entire lower face. Fillers are one mechanism to have that. Of course, lip implants are others, because fillers, in my opinion, work best when they're reliable, which means you know exactly what volume you're going to get, because remember, at the end of the day, you're creating shape. So if you use fat or you use a permanent filler, you may get something that's going to do something in the future, move, create lumps and bumps, or dissolve, in which case you're no longer getting the desired volume.
I've heard you can remove the PermaLip. Is this true?
Yeah, it's an important difference. So the PermaLip is like a silastic implant. You can go in, find it, and easily remove it. The AlloDerm, after a month, it's integrated within the tissues. It's not coming out.
Do you think this would be a good option for my lips?
I would recommend that you would do AlloDerm first, only because you have a very thin lip, so I'm not going to be able to use that thicker one because you don't have enough to cover it. And I could easily get the right proportion. So I would increase the size of your lower lip slightly. I'd use 50% of a sheet, and I'd use an entire sheet for the upper lip. But all of that would be soft and subtle, supple, and in front.
Thank you, Dr. Palmer. I'm so interested in all of this and really want to talk to somebody who's had a procedure done. And thanks to you, I understand that we have someone.
Well, you're very welcome. And yes, we do have somebody for you to speak with.
I must confess, when I think about this type of procedure, I normally think of women doing it. I'm so curious, why did you decide to enhance your lips?
Thanks for having me. I feel that any procedure that you have done should not be gender specific. If it's something that you're uncomfortable with when you look in the mirror and you're unhappy with something, if you're able to change your appearance, why not do it if it makes you happy?
Absolutely. So when you look at your before and after pictures, what do you think?
When I just looked at my before pictures, I was shocked. I couldn't believe how tiny my lip actually was, so I'm very happy with the results.
So when you get up in the morning and look at yourself, do you feel like a different person? How has this changed you?
It's really boosted my confidence level. I was very self-conscious of my lips before, since they were pretty much non-existent. Now I just feel more confident and able to walk out the door with a greater confidence.
You know, having good information helps us make so many better decisions. So thank you so much for sharing your experience with us about lip enhancement.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining me here on Mind Your Body. I'm Stephanie Stevens.